Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
A yoke is something that keeps your destiny in the hands of somebody. Am I speaking to somebody? And we need to have a divine intervention to be released out of that place. Read Acts 12, verse 6.
Acts chapter number 12, verse number 6. The word of the Lord says, "And when Herod was about to bring him out, that night Peter was sleeping, bound with two chains between two soldiers, and the guards before the door were keeping the prison."
Hallelujah, somebody. A prison is a place of limitation. A prison was a place that was a yoke over Peter. I don't know what has been keeping you in prison. I don't know what chains have been put around you. There are prison people watching over you. Today you need a divine visitation, a visitation from angels that shall come through and open the doors that have been holding you down. Today the Lord is sending an angel in your environment, in your situation. Today the doors that have been holding you down are breaking open. You are walking out to your destiny. Hello, somebody. A prison is a place where you can't make a decision for yourself. A prison is a place where you can't even decide what you're going to eat. Everything is decided for you. But the Lord shall release an angel. Hello, somebody.
Amen.
Angels that shall come and release you out. Angels have an assignment over your life. Angels, when they appear in your situation, they either bring a good news of breaking you out of a place of limitation. If you've been living in a place of barrenness, when an angel appears, he will come and tell you, this year, next year, there will be a baby in your house. Ask Father Abraham. It took an angel to come and announce that this year, next year, there shall be a baby in your house. That which has been missing in your environment, that which has been missing in your house, the angel of the Lord is saying, this time, next year, it shall be in your house. Even the mother of Samson, an angel appeared to her and told her, you shall have a child. Am I saying somebody? Even when you're hiding in a place of limitation, speak to Gideon. When an angel appeared before Gideon, he received a breakthrough. He was not a military person. He was converted to a military person, and he was able to defeat the people that were tormenting them. Everything that has been tormenting your life, everything that has been stealing your blessing, we release the favor of Gideon upon your life. May it be released in your life. You are walking to a place of abundance in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
Am I speaking to somebody?
Amen.
So a yoke will limit you. Symptoms, if you want symptoms, somebody says signs. What are signs of limitation in your life? Listen to this. Where you're supposed to be enjoying life, there'll be so much pain. It shows that you are living in a place of bondage. Hallelujah, somebody. In a place where you are supposed to be an asset, you have become a liability. It tells you are living in a place of bondage. In a place where you are supposed to be resting, you are restoring. Hello, somebody. You are fighting with the John Sinners of this world. It means you are living in a place of limitation. Hello, somebody. If you're in a place where you're supposed to only take 5 days, it takes you 15 days. You are in a place of limitation. God shall release an angel that shall come your way to push you to your destiny in Jesus' mighty name. Am I speaking to somebody today? You have to get annoyed. You have to get annoyed. Every spirit of delay over your life today is being cancelled in Jesus' mighty name.
Amen.
I'm reminded of Joseph. When his brothers appeared in Egypt, he put an extra robe in one of them. And when they had gone a distance, he would tell his friend a distance. When they had gone a distance, not just a distance, when they had gone far away, they were pursued and taken back because they found an extra load in their parcel. Any person that has put an extra load on your life, may they die in Jesus' mighty name. They will not waste your time this year. This year you're moving to your place of destiny. This year you're moving to your place of release. This year everything that has been holding you down shall break in Jesus' mighty name. It is a year of arising. It is a year of shining. It is a year of receiving the favor of God upon your life. That extra load that you have been carrying, that extra load that has caused you to go back to your starting point, today may it be broken over your life in Jesus' mighty name. Do you understand that somebody can put an extra load in your bag? Somebody can make you have an extra load that you can carry. Go and read the book of Genesis. You realize that Joseph's brother were given an extra load that they carried. And that thing has to be broken over your life. Extra load over your life has to die in Jesus' mighty name. I am talking about the yoke breaker. And Jesus is your yoke breaker. In conclusion, children of God, I want us to read Jeremiah 50, verse 33 to 34. I want us to read Jeremiah 50, verse 33 to 34. Even every spirit of corrective bondage over your life has to break in Jesus' mighty name. Do you realize you and your family can be held in a place of bondage? You and your generation can be held in a place of bondage until Jesus appears in your situation. You continue living in that place. Jesus today is saying, he's releasing you from a place of bondage, from a corrective power that has been hanging over your life. Today it has to break in Jesus' mighty name. Amen.
Jeremiah chapter number 50, verse 33 to 34. The word of the Lord says, thus says the Lord of hosts, the children of Israel were oppressed along with the children of Judah.
The children of Israel were oppressed with who?
The children of Judah.
That is what I'm calling a collective what? Bondage, yoke over your life.
All who took them captive have held them fast. They have refused to let them go. Their Redeemer is strong. The Lord of hosts is his name. He will thoroughly plead their case, that he may give rest to the land and disquiet the inhabitants of Babylon.
Read it again, young man. I want the congregation to listen to this very well.
Thus says the Lord of hosts.
Thus says the Lord of hosts.
The children of Israel were oppressed, along with the children of Judah. All who took them captive have held them fast. They have refused to let them go.
Those that have been holding you in captivity are refusing to let go of you. Remember, even the children of Israel, one time they were in Egypt, as the whole tribe, the 12 tribes were held together under Egypt. And Pharaoh was refusing to let go of them. Even in this situation, they were refusing to let go of them. You who has been holding you as a collective family under the spirit of oppression, may that break in Jesus' mighty name. May every spirit of poverty that has been hanging on your family, today may it be broken in Jesus' mighty name. May every spirit of stagnation that has been holding you down, may it break in Jesus' mighty name. May every spirit of failure that has been holding you down, you and your family, you and your brothers, may it break in Jesus' mighty name.
Verse number 34. Their Redeemer is strong.
Their Redeemer, your Redeemer is strong. Your Jesus is strong. Your yoke breaker is strong. Your yoke breaker is in the environment. Your yoke breaker is here today. Your yoke breaker is saying, that which has been holding you down, may it be broken in Jesus' name. mighty name. Hallelujah, somebody.
The Lord of hosts.
The Lord of hosts is his name.
He will thoroughly break their curse.
He will break your curse.
That he may give rest to the land.
That he may give rest to you. Whatever pain you have been going through, Jesus has risen. Jesus is in the environment. Jesus is your redeemer. He wants you to go loose. That which has been holding your family, that which has been holding your business, that which has been holding your career down, Jesus has appeared and he's saying, it is your year of rest. It is your year of release. It is your year of moving forward. He said, may it be broken in Jesus' mighty name. Arise, congregation. I need people that can pray that, Father, release me from every spirit of bondage that has been hanging over my life. That thing that has been holding me down, may it be broken in the mighty name of Jesus. I want people that can pray. I want people that can command a situation that has been in their life. I want people that can command that power that has been holding them down. Open your mouth. Command that situation. Command that power. Command that demon that has been holding you down. Command it to break. Command it to break. Open your mouth. Fire prayer. Command that situation that has been holding you down. That which has been holding you down. That which has caused you to be in a place of operation. That which has compelled you to be in a prison. May the Lord release an angel for you. May the Lord turn around things for you. I command every spirit, every yoke of wickedness, every yoke of wickedness to be broken over your life, over your family, over your children. I command that yoke, the yoke of oppression that has been touching you, that has been fighting you, to be broken over your situation. May you get tired. May you rebel. May you say, I am tired of being in a certain place of solitude. Every spirit of woman that has been hanging over your life, may it break down. May it break down. May it break down. Every spirit of sin examination that has been hanging over you, may it break down. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Release prayer. A closed mouth is a closed person. A closed mouth is a closed person. Open your mouth. Open your mouth. Command that yoke that has been holding you down, that has been tormenting you. Command every Goliath in your life that has been causing you not to move forward. Command every Goliath that has been causing you to be in the place of bondage. Command it to die. Command it to die. Oh, yeah. That situation that has kept you at the pool of Messiah. That situation that has told you to be at the pool of Messiah for 30 years. For the 30 years, he commanded to break loose. Break loose. That is the better. That has been holding you down. Let it be broken up. Let it be broken up. Let it be broken up. Oh, yeah, but I wish it was.
Need to have in the name of the Lord every satanic yoke that you are the enemy.